Every time I did a video about a roasted maple neck guitar, this guitar kept coming up. The second thing is, a lot of you guys kept asking me about American Music Supply, have I purchased from them? And ironically, I used to buy from them all the time, especially using their payment plans, when my kids were little. So I went online and checked it out, and I was really shocked to see that you guys were right. They still do it the same way they did before. They have an option where you can do a credit check and you actually don't have to pay any interest, or there's an option where you can do a non-credit check. But either way, this is a great way to get yourself into a much nicer guitar and not worry about coming up with the lump sum right at the same time. There's nothing wrong with saving. That's always a good option too, but I'm just letting you know your options. Let's go ahead and unbox this guitar. So, all right, so what do we got here? We got packing material. We got the sheet that tells us what's in the box. And of course, it is double boxed. With the secondary box. This, of course, is made in Mexico, in the Ensenada factory, by Fender. Sorry about that. And more bubble wrap. And okay, so you have your tremolo arm. This is this stuff. I've owned a lot of made in Mexico products. This seems very typical the way it's set up. Okay, good weight. Do the unveil. Look at that. Wow. So what do we have? We have a made in Mexico Charvel with roasted maple neck, locking keys, tremolo, Seymour Duncan pickups, satin finish. This is army green. I don't care what they call it. I'm not even going to look it up. This is why I wanted the guitar. I wanted it because it's army green. And on the back of the headstock, it's got the sticker that says this guitar headstock is the registered trademark of the Fender Musical Instruments Corporation and is being used with express permission of FMIC. If you see that and you don't know what that means, let me explain it to you real simple. Back before Fender owned Charvel and Jackson, when they were their own companies, they had worked out a legal agreement for licensing. In other words, Charvel would have to pay a licensing royalty to use this headstock shape. This is a trademark of Fender guitars. Even though they are owned now by Fender, they still hold to this weird licensing agreement. I know it's strange. I just thought I'd tell you what it means because this is a Fender headstock shape. It is owned by Fender as a trademark, and it's being licensed by Charvel, even though Charvel is owned by Fender now. You're gonna need to set how you want your tremolo arm to feel. So what happens in the back here, there is an Allen screw. We tighten it up a little bit. I want it to be like wherever I leave it, it stays. It's not super light, it's not super heavy. If I was gonna say 7.5, it's under 8 pounds, over 7. So that's in the range you want it to be. It feels really good. Aluminate dots on the side. These are not stainless steel frets. So things we want to talk about for sure. The neck is thin. It's thinner than I remember my SoCal to feel, just a little bit. This feels more like how I remember the old Charvels feeling. So it's impressive. This is my favorite Charvel neck I think I've ever just picked up and touched. I love saying this. A neck is like a handshake. You reach out to it and you grab it just like this. And within seconds, you just know whether or not that's going to feel right. And to me, this neck feels perfect. I love the radius on the fretboard. I love the frets. I love the contoured body. Some players really, really like the rounded, more Strat style, Charvel style guitars. I was looking for something like this. Something that's kind of like my Jackson guitar body shape. I necessarily didn't want HSS. I kind of just humbucker was fine, but I have no problem with the single coil being there. I really like the idea of the white onto the army green. I just think that's really crazy and fun. I love the way that they, I like that they use the white ivory dots on this. Like I said, some of the things I've said in the past about other roasted necks, I don't like it when they're using the black dots or the dark dots. It's a little hard to see against this darker color wood. So makes no sense to me. The nut is cut really nice. There doesn't seem to be any issues. I love the spindle truss rod for the adjustment. I think that's smart. Alder body. I took the back off so you can see that the block is a real piece of steel. It looks nice. It's interesting that the paint's exposed. They didn't paint that. They painted it and then they routed that out. So I thought that was kind of interesting, but you know, it's cool. It does not come with strap locks or a gig bag, so if it's something you thought you might get included with the guitar or a case, it doesn't have that. So you'll be prepared that if you order this online and those are things you want, you're gonna have to order them at the same time or make sure you have them. It's using the frictionless potentiometer. I can tell from the volume pots, really nice. And of course it has the no load tone potentiometer, which means when it clicks forward, it's out of the circuit, so you're not putting a load against the pickups, and that gives you a little brighter sound if you want the more cutting tone. A couple things I was shocked to see or impressed by was I didn't know or didn't pay attention that it has steel block. I thought that was a nice little add that I didn't expect. I also didn't think that the neck was going to feel this thin. I picked up a couple before and I was really pleasantly shocked to feel that it feels kind of like my Jackson guitar. I have a Dinky Jackson made in Japan and the necks feel very similar. In fact, this might be just a little thinner. I picked up one or two here and there and I've liked most of the ones I picked up. I think I picked up one in a store that didn't feel too good, but I didn't know if that was because it had been demoed to death. It could have been, you know, a culprit. All the ones that I picked out, I picked up in places where I know they didn't get a whole lot of traffic on them have felt really good like this. So something to think about when you're looking at that. I know because this guitar was so heavily requested that you guys will want a comparison video with some or one of the other roasted maple neck guitars I've done in before. And what I'd like you to do is put in the comments down below what guitar you would like me to compare it to, do an A-B shootout with. And if we get 1,000 likes, I will pick whatever the most requested comparison guitar to this is and do a shootout between the two and let you know what I feel about the necks, maybe the quality, all that stuff, just to see. Because like I said, I've been in a roasted maple neck mood lately, apparently. So we'll go with that. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I sure enjoyed this guitar. As always, I put links down below to everything I discussed in this video. And until next time, thank you so much for your time and know your gear. It's probably a good time to mention, I don't know if people noticed that I have two intros to my videos. So I wanna play both, because I've never thought about it until I just played that right now for you guys. There's two different ones.